Welcome to this hypothesis testing tutorial on using Excel's data analysis tool for a one sample Z test for mean. We'll be demonstrating how to generate a modified output like what you see here on screen. Our example involves a fitness app claiming that users exercise for 30 minutes daily. We have a sample of 50 users with a mean exercise time of 32 minutes, a population standard deviation of 8 minutes, and we're testing at a 3% significance level. Excel's data analysis typically requires raw data, but we'll create a workaround here using summary statistics. In this column titled Observation Number, let's create numbers 1 to 50, since the sample size is 50. Type 1 in the first cell, then 2 under it. Select both and drag the fill handle down all the way to 50. In the data column, enter the sample mean of 32 in the first cell. Double-click the fill handle to replicate this value for all 50 observations. In the dummy column, enter 0 in the first cell. The setup is now complete. Now let's generate the Z-test output. Click the Data tab. If you don't see data analysis here, you'll need to enable it. On Mac, go to Tools, Excel Add-ins, and check the Analysis Tool Pack box. On Windows, right-click the ribbon, select Customize the ribbon, click Add-ins, then click Go. Check Analysis Tool Pack box and click OK. Now click the Data tab, click Data Analysis. Scroll down to the end and select Z-test 2 sample for means. Click OK. For variable 1 range, I'm going to click on the data column title, Ctrl-Shift down arrow to select the entire column. For variable 2 range, select the dummy title and the 0. For hypothesized mean difference, input 30, since we're testing if the population mean equals 30. Now, the population standard deviation sigma is known to be 8. Thus, the population variance will be 8 squared, which gives 64. So, for variable 1 variance, enter 64. Since there is really no variable 2, for variable 2 variance, enter a very small value like 0.0000001. Check the labels box and change the alpha value to 0.03, the significance level. Click OK. And here is the output. Right-click on column C and delete the dummy column. Rename the output to Z-test 1 sample mean. And there it is. We've used data analysis in Excel to perform a one sample Z-test for mean using summary data. Looking at the output, we see that the test statistic is not greater than the critical values for both one-tailed and two-tailed tests. This indicates that we should fail to reject the null hypothesis in both scenarios, suggesting that the results are not statistically significant. Likewise, the p-values for both one-tailed and two-tailed tests are greater than our alpha of 0.03. This corroborates our decision not to reject the null hypothesis in either case. In the context of our fitness app example, there is insufficient statistical evidence to conclude that the average user exercises for more than 30 minutes per day. In the two-tailed case, there is insufficient evidence to conclude that the average user's exercise time differs significantly from 30 minutes per day. And that's it. Thanks for watching.